Isaac was 40 years old when he married Rebekah, the daughter of Bethuel the Aramean. She was unable to conceive, so Isaac prayed to the Lord on her behalf. And 20 years later, when Isaac was 60, his prayer was answered. Rebekah became pregnant, and the children struggled together within her womb, causing her to inquire of the Lord.
Why is this happening to me?
Oh. And the Lord said to her,
"There are two nations in your womb. From birth they will be divided. One will be stronger than the other, and the older will serve the younger."
Now, when the time came for Rebekah's delivery, she gave birth to twins. The first to be born was red and covered all over with hair like a coat. They named him Esau. When the second child came out, his hand was grasping Esau's heel. That child was named Jacob. As the brothers grew, they were very different. Jacob was a quiet man who stayed inside the tents, while Esau became a skilled hunter. Their father, Isaac, had an appetite for game, so he favored his son Esau, while Rebekah favored Jacob. One day, as Jacob was cooking stew, his brother came to him.
"I am exhausted. Let me have some of that stew."
"First, sell me your birthright."
"My birthright?" "Agreed. I am about to die anyway. What good is it to me?"
"Swear it, Esau."
Despising his birthright, Esau swore it to his younger brother Jacob that day. Esau ate and drank and walked away. There came a famine upon the land of Canaan, and Isaac went to Gerar on his way toward Egypt. And the Lord God appeared to Isaac.
"Do not go down into Egypt. Live in the land that I will tell you. I will fulfill the promise I made to your father Abraham. I will multiply your offspring, making them as numerous as the stars in the heavens. I will give these lands to your descendants, and by them all the nations of the world will be blessed. I will do this because your father Abraham obeyed all that I commanded."
So Isaac settled in Gerar. When the men of Gerar asked Isaac about Rebekah, out of fear he said,
"She's my sister."
But it so happened that after Isaac had been there a long time, Abimelech, king of the Philistines, saw him caressing Rebekah. So Abimelech summoned Isaac and said,
"Rebekah is your wife. Why would you say she is your sister?"
"I was afraid to lose my life because of her."
"One of the men could have slept with her, and you would have brought guilt upon us."
So King Abimelech warned all the people.
"Anyone who touches this man or his wife shall be put to death."
As time passed, the Lord God blessed Isaac, and he became very wealthy. He harvested more than he planted, and his flocks and herds multiplied. This caused jealousy among the Philistines, and in their envy, they filled his wells with dirt. Then Abimelech said to Isaac,
"Go away from us, for you have become much mightier than we are."
So Isaac left from there and stayed in the valley of Gerar. He uncovered two more wells that his father had dug, but the people of Gerar also quarreled over those. He continued his search, eventually arriving in Beersheba. And that very night, the Lord God appeared to him.
"Do not be afraid, for I am with you. I am the God of your father Abraham, and for his sake, I will bless you and increase your descendants.
Isaac settled in the land of Beersheba. There he built an altar, and his servants dug a well. It was then that King Abimelech, along with his advisor and the captain of his army, came to Isaac. And Isaac asked them,
"Why have you come to me, seeing that you hate me and sent me away?"
"We see clearly that the Lord is with you and has blessed you. So let us make a treaty together."
Isaac prepared for them a feast. And early the next morning, they swore an oath to each other. Then Isaac sent them on their way in peace. That very day, his servants came to him, saying,
"We have found water."
So Isaac named the well Sheba. And to this day, the city is called Beersheba, the Well of Oath.
Jacob said, "Sell me your birthright now." Esau said, "I am about to die. Of what use is a birthright to me?" Jacob said, "Swear to me now." So he swore to him and sold his birthright to Jacob. Then Jacob gave Esau bread and lentil stew, and he ate and drank and rose and went his way. Thus Esau despised his birthright. Genesis chapter 25, verses 31 to 34.